for the motion. Make in India initiative was launched in September 2014 as part of government's renewed focus on boosting manufacturing sector. The first of all, achievements. It has a tremendous impact on the investment climate of the country with a significant 46% of foreign direct investment equity inflows and highest ever FDI of $55.5 billion. Along with that, the growth rate, GDP growth rate, has risen to 7.6% and projected to grow more than 7% till 2020, according to the International Monetary Fund. So definitely, Make in India is beginning to bear its fruits. Thank you.
So my mate has given a very good definition about what Make in India is all about. But has Make in India made what it has been set up to? When we started with Make in India, it was all about establishing new companies in India so that we can put market Indian products in international markets. But today, we have been just reduced to put forward and bring setups from America or other companies or just copy what other people are doing. It is just like Lenovo produced in India under the name of Lenovo itself. So what has Make in India done for us? Where it was to be establishing and putting up new projects in India, it has just been reduced to copying what others are doing. So has Make in India made its mark? That's what I would like to ask. Thank you.
My worthy opponent just mentioned that it is to set up new companies. According to the exact sentence that, which is in the Make in India official website, it is to create incentives, reward innovation and create in the country. That's why foreign direct investment means that they are using our resources and just infrastructure is theirs. Also, you said copy. We have to compete with the entire world. And the main idea of Make in India is to boost manufacturing sector. The countries which are on the top are the best manufacturing sectoring countries. We have to cope up with them. We have to boost up our manufacturing sector. Also, FDI, the foreign direct investment, is a reason.
For this, I would like to add that even if they want to, like, you know, they want to boost manufacturing in India, the thing that it started with was Make in India failed in the aspect would be that the capital investment that it was supposed to give us, the government was supposed to give us, they are not providing. The idea, we can take an idea to them, but they don't guarantee us the startup money that they are supposed to. And also, I would like to add is the tax exemption that the government was supposed to give. It was only been that, you know, if you start the project and later on, if you have the money, then you can start the project. But if you go to some capital and venture capitalists and they take an idea, there's no patent for it.
Okay, so basically, one of the most important thing that after Make in India, what was started was Skill India, which has many funds, many companies, and many people have together put up money for it. And with the help of Skill India funds, the government has started to prepare the people. They have 163 training centers. It's all for skill development, and this is definitely helping the people to bring up more money. GDP. The GDP has risen from 26 trillion USD to 1.87 USD trillion to 2.64 trillion USD. It has increased.
So basically what my opponent told was, we have skill development centers. But is that skill development center giving us enough opportunity to come out with new projects? What is the guarantee today, as my friend told, what is the guarantee today that in that skill development center, I take my plan, I go over there and I give it in front of someone and tell, this is my plan, this is how I want to work. What is the guarantee that this plan will come out under my name? Is there patenting? Is it put in the plan of Make in India? Has it been totally put up together? From the start, we are just saying Make in India, Make in India, Make in India. 3 years down, we are 3 years down in Make in India, and still now we don't have a single company except for Patanjali, which is not working basically because of its quality, but because of the brand ambassador being Ramdev Baba. Do we have anything more other than that coming up? We have Oppo and Vivo from China coming to India.
So when you said about your patent, let me say that in India, it is not this Make in India is not about a single person, but it is about developing a country. And now, if you have read the newspaper, today's newspaper, it says that India is now the fastest growing economy. And Make in India has had a very good role in this. And the GDP. Yes, also that we must remember that the topic is, if Make in India is beginning to bear fruit, it has only been 3 years. And within 3 years, if Make in India has been able to come up with this many ideas and increase in GDP, definitely within the next few years, we would increase the, we would have more companies, Indian companies, we would be able to be one of the developed countries.
I would like to conclude it this way, that at last it's just Make in India has not been what it's set up for. It was supposed for for us to get our ideas forward and take it for now it's just an invitation of abroad companies that are coming here and developing whatever later on. But it's our brand, what we were supposed to put out, that is not there right now. And also I would put some changes in the Make in India plan would be from my side, that you know how recently there's a RERA thing for real estate industry, like that, if there is something for us, some new administration that we can take to them, they can give us guarantee for patent, they can give us guarantee of the secured pricing, of the tax exemption that they're giving, if it is accounted